I'm gonna learn parkour moves like vaults and running on walls with absolutely no experience. And then I'm gonna attempt a full run at the end. The first move I decided to try is the basic of parkour, and it's called vault. Vaults are all the parkour techniques used to go quickly over obstacles, and there are a bunch of them, like a lot. But in this video, I'm gonna learn four of them. I started with the safety vault, which is considered to be probably the easiest one. It's not as intimidating to perform as what's coming next, but it gave me a nice boost of confidence when I realized I could do it without practice.
Yes! Let's freaking go! This is so cool!
From here, I could also easily learn the speed vault by simply running up to the obstacle and this time swinging both legs to one side and then keep running. Now, if the wall is on your side, you need to use the third vault out of four on the list, which name, by the way, perfectly suits my personality, the lazy vault. The lazy vault is used for moving over an obstacle sideways or diagonally while still running or moving forwards. So we need to place one hand on the object and force the inside leg over it. Then, by pushing off with the outside leg and swinging both legs over the object, the vault is done.
It's so nice.
Doing this at full speed is a little bit more uncomfortable than the previous one. I kept having the idea of landing on my face for some reason, but after a few minutes, I got it and I tried to use it over a bunch of different objects.
Now things start to get interesting,
because the next vault is the coolest, scariest, and most difficult of the list, and it's called Kong Vault. This one is used in parkour for moving over an object and gaining distance, like in the case you're jumping over a hole like this guy.
All right, do not do that.
This one is scary, because you need to completely commit to do it.
I am extremely convinced that if I try this on a high object, I will stumble with my feet and land with my nose.
And that's why I decided to get used to the movement by trying at ground level first, moving to taller objects later.
It's a bit uncomfortable doing it like that, but it's a safe way to do it. We don't want to hurt ourselves. Alright.
It starts by launching with your legs and diving the air, then placing the hands on the obstacle and pushing it off. Then at this point you should bring the legs into a tucked position and landing, hopefully, on the feet. I practiced for a while and when I got confident enough,
I'm not confident at all,
I decided to try on a longer obstacle, about 1 mic long. At first I was a bit intimidated, but I kept trying over and over and I always landed a little bit further. I practiced until I continuously got extremely close, like every single time. Then after 10 minutes my hand gave up on me, but still I was insane. Really happy about the progress I made.
Alright, I think that's my limit, but it's pretty damn good.
The next parkour move I wanted to learn before attempting the full run is the wall run, both vertical and horizontal.
I've always wanted to try this, but I never did, so I'm super pumped.
Starting with the horizontal run, my goal is to make 3 steps on a vertical wall. To do this, you need to focus your chakra on the bottom of your feet. I started trying intuitively, and I could only manage to take 1 or 2 steps. I was basically bouncing off the wall as soon as I touched it. And I kept trying for a while, until finally, something clicked. The first mistake I was making was running towards the wall with the wrong angle, not enough parallel to the wall. The second mistake is about the way I was landing on the wall. By pushing with my legs, I was simply bouncing off. Instead, the key is to absorb the energy of the run while making really close steps. I tried for a while, and with these tips, after about 10 minutes, I got consistent with it. The second type of wall run is the perfect way to escape from someone, something, or imaginary enemies, and it's the vertical wall run. Once you master this technique, it could be possible to climb 10 to 15 foot walls, which is absolutely insane. There is no way I could reach the top of this wall by simply jumping, so I started trying. In theory, the faster you run into the wall, the easier it gets to jump higher or crashing against it. So I started trying with a quick jog and then sprinting once I got closer to the obstacle, and with big surprise, I got it.
The thing is about to break, but yeah, I kinda get it.
So then I tried with different walls. In the beginning, I was trying really carefully, and I still managed to get on top of normal walls. But then, I tried with this one. And this time, I decided to just go 100% and see how high I could jump with my arm.
I don't wanna jump in anyone's property, but it would be absolutely insane if I could reach the end of the wall, but like, here.
And I totally wasn't expecting it, but this happened.
I did it. I did it, that's insane.
Once you kick the wall, the key is to fully extend the arm you use to reach the top of the wall, while the other arm stays like this to prevent you using your face to stop the run in case you do something wrong. And right here is when I realized that I forgot to learn the most important move, how to fall. The technique parkour athletes use is called safety roll. Imagine being able to fall from any height without hurting yourself. Plus, when I usually fall, I fall hard, so I absolutely need this one. The key is not to roll on your spine, but slightly on one side. For me, it's the right one. And using the arms to kinda lift yourself up a little bit, avoiding to smash the shoulder on the ground. Then I tried to drop from a higher place.
I'm doing this just for you.
And after a few tries that hurt, I managed to land in a beautiful, painless way.
That wasn't that bad. Alright, let's do the run.
I decided to combine all the tricks together in a full parkour run. And this is how it turned out. Speed vault into a Kong vault. And then a safety vault. twice, running as fast as possible into a horizontal wall run and then a vertical wall run. And finally, the most dangerous move. I decided to jump off this wall, trying with a sort of Kong vault. But then, this happened.
I don't know how, but I'm fine.
I'm not gonna lie, I thought I was done for a moment while I was in the air, but I didn't want to give up. So then I tried again, this time taking a leap of faith and simply ignoring the wall and jumping in the air. And not only I survived, but it turned out pretty cool.
It's all about practice.
Thank you for watching Shakes. Subscribe for more skills every single week.